Hey guys, and today I have the DC motor on my wife's, and I'm making this video about how to remove the gear from the DC motor. And because sometimes it's cheaper to get a cheap motor and replace the gear on the AC to repair the tool or your controller to a car for the kids. Yeah, and we have the gear here, and I don't have the gap here to put the puller out. And what can I do? I can hit the gear to lift it up with a flat screwdriver, like this one, for example. And I will do that now. Of course, this motor is dead, so I can easily damage it. I can try to punch the ass of it with a hammer. Maybe I will get the gap. Yeah, I can see that now I have the gap here. Now you can see. Okay, you will see now. Now I have the gap here, and I can put the screwdrivers here. I'm just getting it a little bit deeper. Yep, I still will try to hit it. Of course, you need to hit it well to get it easily out from the anvil, from the accessory, not anvil. Yeah, some grease going out. That's not a problem for us. It will be only a fire. Okay, I'll try to remove it now. And yep, as you can see, I can remove it easily. Now I'm taking it with the pliers and trying to take it out. Yep, it's out and it's all healthy, good and nice. Yeah, as you can see, it's really easy to remove the gear. And sometimes the genuine motor costs 30, 40 or more euros, and not a genuine but good motor cost for 10 or 15 euros, and you need just to replace the gear. Yep, and it's a really, really easy job for that. So yeah, that was only the short video about how to replace the gear for the DC motor. Of course, you need to press the new gear on the new motor. We can do that now. I have that was the Bosch motor, and I have the Makita motor now that costs 3 times less, and I get removed the gear from it. Okay, now you have a couple ways to put a new gear on the motor. You can hit the gear and put it on the AC. It's probably the best way to do that. Just take the one part I need. Yep, just don't forget that you need to support this AC of the motor. It's on the back. Now I'm supporting it, and just tighten the vise a little bit. Okay, now it's supported, and you can see that. Okay, now we have the gear here, and I'm just putting it on the SM, and of course now hitting it again. And when you hit the metal, it expands, and that makes you more space to move it to take it on the SM. That's that simple. It's a common question in the repair shop and in my email. But of course, don't be hesitant to write emails for me. You can find the contacts in the channel info. I'm always happy to reply you, because sometimes it's easier for me to write an email back than to connect to the YouTube and write a comment back. Yeah, and really appreciate your comments and yeah, your good words about my jab. Okay, now we can knock the gear slightly. It's moving and it's not good for us. I will do that in another way. I will just put it on with the vise. Okay, you have the socket itself. Now 9mm socket, I will put it like this one on the gear. And I will press the gear on the IC with a vise, and it's a really, really simple, easy way. Okay, just pressing it on. Yep. Yep, we have the gear on the motor, and the motor is now ready again to work. Yeah. Oh, that was the really, really easy gear replacement. Of course, if you have the vise and the socket and the lighter. Just if you need more videos like this for how to do one or other thing, just write in the comments or the email, and I will do my best to do that. So just for now, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and see you next day. Bye.